In this text ring Jewelry CAD tutorial mini series number 1, you are going to learn 2 things. First, how to design text flat on the surface in Rhino 6 and what need to be watched for 3D printing. Second, how to flow the design to a ring band. Let's get started. For the first ring that we are doing here, we want the text flow all the way around. So I have here PJ Chen Design 2018. You can use any font in this kind of a design, but I will actually suggest to use any text that is bold and heavy. The text I'm using, it's called Burning Sand FB. This is a little bit funky looking. So let's take a look on how we're gonna do this. I'm going to delete this first. All right, so first of all, you need to decide the ring shank because we don't want anything cutting inside of ring shank. This one is 16 millimeter in diameter. And when we find out, the next things we need to find out is the circumference. So let's just type it length. Then it shows 50.265. So I'm going to draw a line there, type it 50.265, enter. And then you will have the length is this, the same with this circumference. So what we need to do is we need to design within this area. So let's go to the top view. So now we want to bring in the text. Let's go to the text command. And right here, you can decide how big do you want it. Let's say 10 millimeter, and we do want a solid. We don't have to group it together. And then you can add in the space if you want to. Let's set up for 0 first. And right here, I'm going to type it PJ Chen Design 2018. So the font that I was using, let me pick up those, and it's Berlin Sand FB. You can use any font that you like, but I happen to pick up this one. It's a little bit funkier. This text look really thin to me, so I'm gonna do one more time and make sure the bowl is on, so they will look much heavier. So now let me scale it down a little bit and try to fit into where that length is. Get it really close, something like that. We can have it a little bit bigger because we need to actually put all the text inside. Now let's take a look on this. We need to have them ungroup first, and I need to move them as close as possible. So I'm gonna move this one here. Be careful on this. If your contact is too small, for example, you have this one, just barely contact that. That's going to create a lot of casting issue. First of all, it's too sharp in this area, and you may have an investment breaking in there. And second, the metal won't flow through it. So make sure that they have very good contact. At the same time, it's still visible for reading. So now I'm going to move the text close to the center one by one. And then you can get it a little bit more creative. For example, you don't want them to be all the same, you know, like something like this, tilt it a little bit, rotate it a little bit, so to make it more fun. In my case, if that is your design, in my case, I want to make it a little bit funkier, so I kind of try to twist it, you know, things like that, so you won't look like all the way the same. And be careful, if you have an eye, make sure that eye is touching the body as well. Okay, so we kind of do a little bit of adjustment here and there and things like that. And you can scale some of them to be bigger, some of them to be smaller. And then we just gonna keep doing it until we find what we like. And I'm also gonna make 2018 a little bit bigger. So this is a little bit tweak here and there. Okay, and then after that, we got everything there. Let's take a look on it and see if you like it. And sometimes what you can do also is, let's say P and C and D, and maybe 2018. I want them to be a little bit bigger, so I may want to scale up a little bit. That's one way to do it. Or you just want them to be a little bit taller. So let's go ahead to do 1D scale and scale it up, something like this. So it's kind of jump up, you know, like certain character right there. All right, so now what we like to do is we like to boolean the whole things together. All right, so this is actually very interesting things. Sometimes this is a computer glitch in the Rhino. You kind of see that something is weird. It's kind of empty, even though you appear to be having a faces there, but it looked like it's broken. So let's take a look on the property. It say close, solid, poly surface. All right, but let's take a look on the render. All right, in render view, it's disappear. I don't see, you know, the surface there is so weird. All right, so it gotta be something wrong on that. So let's go back one step. And I intentionally wanna show you this because that might be what you're facing. One way to do it is maybe some sort of something wrong on this geometry. So I will try the first is to explode it, because this is showing it's a closed extrusion, which means it's extruded from the curve. So I will do is I will explode it, and then I will join this back. Very quickly, you see as soon as I explode it, this surface, it's weird, it doesn't read it. So I'm going to delete this one and that one, and I'm going to join all of them back, and then I also going to use the command cap. So now it is a poly surface. Let's try to boolean this one and that one and see what happened. Still it's making something weird like that. So the surface, not only is the surface has a problem, is actually go back to the really original one, which is the curve. So the second way to fix that, if the first way doesn't fix it, let's move on to the second way. So we're gonna pick up the text that has the problem, and let me create a new layer and send those to this layer. Okay, and then we are going to close everything else. Okay, so now what we have is those texts over there. I'm going to do is duplicate the age on the bottom, right? So once we create this, we want to join them while they are just created, and then we can go ahead to delete the text because that is where the problem is. All right, so let's take a look on the top view. Now, something about this curve has the problem. So what we can do is we can rebuild this curve. And when we rebuild it, you don't have to build it too much difference. You can choose whatever close to original, or you can actually change it if you want to. So I'm going to set it 60 here and I click OK. For those two, I'm going to rebuild as well, and I'll do 60 as well. So let's turn on the other layer that we have there. We want to use as a guideline to know what the high is supposed to be. Since we use a 1.2 for the text, but we kind of scale it down, we don't know exactly how much is it now. So let's go to the solid, extruded planar curve straight, and we want to go up to here, so they are the same height. Now let's do one more time. If I just do a test, I want to boolean this one to that one, then that's no problem. Okay, perfect. So let's go ahead to boolean all of them. Now you see there's no problem, no weird surface, and that's how I will fix it. Okay, so let's go to the top view. Now the text has no problem. We need to make sure that when they flow to back to that ring, it will connect the end of the 2018, the age of the 8 will connect to the P on the left side. So let's go ahead to align those right in the middle. And we need to make sure that this is a scale up to just a little bit over so they will touch it there. Okay. gonna pick up the curve and just temporarily hide it. So now we have this text, we need to flow it back to this part. Make sure that the curve that we have, let's take a look on the top, front view. The curve that we have is actually represent this curve right there. So make sure that everything is aligned to the bottom, to the zero on the x-axis. Sorry, on the z-axis, so that way it will flow exactly there. So let's take a look on the perspective one more time. This time, let's use the command. Under the transform, you have flow along curve, and we want to pick up the text, and then we're going to zoom in to pick up the curve. We're going to come in here to pick up the curve here. So let's take a look. All right, the reason it is backward and is also cutting inside of a ring because the direction on the curve that I pick is opposite with the curve that we built, originally. So let me do one more time. This time, let's go to pick up the object and we're gonna pick up from this end instead. And then we're gonna come back to the curve over here. So now it's flow correctly. And then you see the gap right there. So this is gonna be incomplete casting. We need to have it flow all the way. So I forgot to do one thing is, let's go back one more time, is we need to record the history. So let's do one more time. We wanna go for transform, flow along the curve, and we need to record the history. And let's pick up the object and we're gonna pick up the curve and then we're gonna pick it over here. So now it's the same issue right there, but if I kind of scale a little bit like this way, and you're going to see it's kind of moving, and maybe that is touching too much now. Maybe I want to scale it back just a little bit, and then you can see it will change over there. So it can adjust into whatever you like. All right. I hope you like this short video for how to make the text ring number 1, and we will come back for number 2. Thank you for watching. Please like and leave a comment so I will able to make more free video for you. See you next Monday.